What's up guys, in today's video I'm going to be showing you 5 mistakes beginners make and how to avoid them, and I'd like you guys to stay tuned to the end of this video as I'm going to be showing you a great tip on how to organize your model. Let's go. Okay, welcome guys, this is Rod, iConcept Architect, and if you're new to this channel, I'd like you to hit the subscribe button down below and also click on the notification bell that comes up next. Now guys, in today's video I'm going to be showing you 5 mistakes beginners make and how to avoid them. Let's go straight into the first mistake. So the number one mistake SketchUp users make is not using the autosave option, and many 3D artists have suffered from not saving their SketchUp file, whereby they work for hours and suddenly SketchUp goes, it crashes. So this has caused so many depression among architects and 3D artists, and the best way to solve this is to use the autosave option embedded in SketchUp. And to do that, all you have to do is go to Windows, click on Preference and locate the General tab, and make sure you check on the autosave button and set the time for autosave 5 minutes. I like using 5 minutes because the shorter the time, the more your SketchUp hangs. So I'll just check the button of create backup to and click on OK. So after you do that, all you have to do is continue working on your model. Even without saving, SketchUp automatically saves your model after every 5 minutes. So even if SketchUp crashes, all you have to do is go back to where you save your model and locate the autosave file, and then you are good to go. Another mistake SketchUp beginners make is not using shortcuts while working in SketchUp, and this tends to slow down your modeling process as you have to select every tool you want to make use of. But using SketchUp shortcuts can greatly increase your productivity, and SketchUp comes with some certain shortcuts, but the best part is you can actually create your shortcut. Normally, if I want to hide this cabinet right here, what I'll do is I'll first select the cabinet like so, then I'll go to edit tab and click on hide. And to unhide it again, I'm going to go to the edit tab and click on unhide all. But I can just press some certain buttons on my keyboard to perform the same task without having to go to the edit tab. So I'll just press the button I've set already as my shortcut to hide and unhide. And to create shortcut, all you have to do is go to Windows and locate preference right here. Then you can locate where shortcut is and look for the shortcut, the command you want to create shortcut for. SketchUp comes with so many commands, so I'm just going to search for the one I need, which is the hide command. So I'm just going to click on the hide and create the shortcut by typing in the shortcut I want to use and click on the plus button right here to assign it. So I'm just going to create a shortcut for the unhide button also, and create a shortcut for the hide rest of component button too. When you're done creating your shortcuts and assigning them, all you have to do is just click OK and then you are good to go. So you may know SketchUp is not a click and drag software, rather a click release, click to complete command software. So many users make this mistake. For example, you use the line tool like this to click, drag, then click, drag, release. Then you click drag release, and this tends to slow down your working process in SketchUp, as you can see in the video right now. But working with SketchUp, the best way to work is click, release, and click to complete command. So this tends to increase your speed working with SketchUp, as you have to, as it will help you navigate better. Now you can see I click and drag for this, then look at this, I click and release for this. As you can see how this SketchUp is very easy to navigate when you click and release. Another mistake SketchUp beginners make is not grouping geometries in SketchUp, and a lot of beginners don't work with groups, and most don't even know they can work with groups in SketchUp. Modeling like this in SketchUp can leave your entire model with sticky geometries that are very difficult to amend later. As you can see right here, this model is not in group, so it will be very difficult for me to move, to rotate, to apply any command to this model, as it's going to cause some kind of funny shape due to stickiness. But over here, everything was created in group, so it's very easy for me to create some amendment and corrections in the future, as I've grouped every part of this model. Okay, as promised earlier, I said I'm going to show you how to organize your model, which is another mistake beginners make when working on SketchUp. They don't organize their model, and this can lead to issues later, especially when working on big projects like this one here. So this model was done and completed working with layers, so I have to on and off some part of the model in order to correct some certain things in the model. So it helps in boosting your productivity and increasing your work speed and organize your models for you. To use layers, all you have to do is open the outliners tab here, open the layers tab, and also open the entity info tab. Now you select a group, then you go to the outliners tab like this and right click. Then you can rename that group in the outliners tab. So I'm just going to call this floor. You click on enter. Then you also go to the layers and create a new layer for that floor you grouped. So I'll just click on this plus button here and then type in floor and press enter. So the entity info is just used to sort out the group into the layer. So I'm just going to go to the layers tab and sort out the group into the floor layer. So when this is done, you can come to the layers here under the visibility tab like this. Then you can hide and unhide. You can just use it as a switch to off and on your component or your groups. So that's how to organize your model in SketchUp. If you haven't subscribed yet, I'd like you to hit the subscribe button down below and also like this video and comment your best tip. Let me know in the comment section your best tip. See you guys in the next video.